Shalom, child of God. Kenyan pastors and prophets has risen against Pastor Benny Hinn's crusade in Kenya. They say that they are not happy, that God is not happy with that crusade. Can you watch this video? I'll be back. Thank you.
After such a big prayer program that happened in Kenya, it takes a maximum of 7 days for the report to come out. 7 days. I'm a prophet and I'm not trying to be. And I know things of the prophets. I decided to check the impact of the prayers of Pastor Benny Hinn, and I've got nothing against him. I've got totally nothing against him. In fact, I am too little to talk about Benny Hinn. I am totally nothing before him, if we go by the standards of humans. I'm not even worthy to open my mouth and call his name. But because I'm a prophet, I will call his name. And I'm a prophet on this land. The prayer that was done by Pastor Benny Hinn in Kenya, it is invalid in the presence of God. The kneeling of the pastors, the kneeling of the men of God behind the president was not right, and God chose his servants to carry his authority and his anointing. So when Benny Hinn told pastors to kneel behind the president, that was abomination before the Lord. And pastors of Kenya, you have a price to pay. But I'm here to tell Benny Hinn, this country has prophets. Those demons will not survive here. They will not survive here. No innocent Kenyan will die as a price. And Benny Hinn, you understand what I'm talking, because we are all in the spirit. You cannot go to sleep in graves and bring those spirits here in Kenya. It will not work. I asked God when I was in Dubai, Lord, why have you brought me to Dubai the time I'm supposed to be down there? I asked God about it. Why have you brought me to Dubai when I'm supposed to be back home constructing your place for worship, fighting? Then the Lord reminded me a dream of 2014, 10 years down the line. A dream of 2014, it was reminded to me. A dream and the date, it was on 2014, January on 14th. God reminded me, do you remember the dream I gave you? Then I remembered that 2014 January on 14th, I had a dream that I was somewhere on the mountain. There's a common mountain at home where I normally go. So there is a place where people go to pray. If you have a gift, you are a pastor, you are a shepherd, you go there, you pray. It's just a portion. There's spirit of shepherd. Apple. So I saw in the dream that I was there, and as I was there, it changed into a country. It was like a country now, and I'm being removed from there. Like now it's a country. It's the same place on the mountain, but now it looks like a country. I'm being removed from there, and I'm being taken to another country for 14 days. Then I'm being told, I'm asking the person who removed me, why are you removing me and I've not finished my prayers? Then he's telling me there is some contamination coming and you have to be separated so that you come back when the contamination is over and save the sheep. I'm seeing some flocks, some sheep with manure. They are there. So when I woke up from the dream, I didn't understand. I thought God was removing me from Kisumu because something was to take place. And I always say one thing. When I don't understand, but I know it, I keep it until the right time to understand. Not everything you must understand. Some things God will tell you so that you keep them, because the time for understanding them has not come. Have I spoken to a mature Christian here? There are times God will give you information so that you may have it, because the time to understand it is not yet. When the time for understanding comes, he will come and tell you, do you remember And you say, oh Lord, I do. Now, this is it. Because the time has come. So, God told you, do you remember the dream? I said, very well, like just yesterday. That is the thing. So, when I was in Dubai, God told me, the time has come. And I asked God, what is the time? 3 weeks down the line before I left here, Martin is my witness. Here. Moses is my witness. Here. Miriam is my witness. Here. 3 times I called the media team. I wanted to pass the message. And immediately they could prepare the cameras. I go blank. Something takes me over, or I find myself doing something. I remember the last day they did the cameras and everything. I told them I'm going down to help myself. I didn't come up. When I came up when the, because God didn't want me to talk about things before the it's time. When I was in Dubai, Martin prepared the camera twice. Billy is my witness. I didn't record anything. And I realized I was fighting with something. I was fighting with the will of God. The will of God was, keep quiet. The time has not come. Keep quiet. The time has not come. Keep quiet. When the time comes, I will tell you to talk. And now I want to talk. After such a big prayer program that happened in Kenya, it takes a maximum of 7 days for the report to talk, to come out. 7 days. 7 days, I am telling you, people of God, 7 days. I'm a prophet, and I'm not trying to be. And I know things of the prophet. Paul says, even if I'm a prophet with the secret and the knowledge of God, and I don't have love, I am useless. So I'm not a prophet because I can prophesy. I'm not a prophet because I can travel in the timelines. But I'm a prophet because I know the secrets of God and the mysteries of God. I decided to check the impact of the prayers of Pastor Benny Hinn. And I've got nothing against him. I've got totally nothing against him. In fact, I am too little to talk about Benny Hinn. I am totally nothing before him, if we go by the standards of humans. I'm not even worthy to open my mouth and call his name. But because I'm a prophet, I will call his name. I'm not calling his name because I'm anywhere closer to his level. I am totally nowhere. But I'm calling his name because I'm a prophet of God. And I'm a prophet on this land. The prayer that was done by Pastor Benny Hinn in Kenya, it is invalid in the presence of God. And I will give the reports. Personally, as a prophet, I went and checked the records of heaven. And all things that were done in Kenya, they were dramas. Minds of people. Politically arranged. But now, Kenya, hear the feedback of God. When you did it, you expected a result. And now here I am with your results. I asked God, why are you giving me such kind of reports when Kenya has powerful servants of God who are driving big vehicles, who have big accounts and big names? I am just nothing but a former street boy. Why are you giving me this kind of information? And God told me, he doesn't go by the standards of humans. He goes by his anointing. He doesn't go by who you think you are. He goes by what he has deposited in his own people. Number one, The kneeling of the pastors, the kneeling of the men of God behind the president was not right, and God chose his servants to carry his authority and his anointing. So when Ben-Hill taught pastors to kneel behind the president, that was abomination before the Lord. And pastors of Kenya, you have a price to pay. God says he anointed you to carry the holy anointing. You need to explain why you went on your knees before, behind a human. Ruto is president, and that has nothing to do with the systems of heaven. If there is anything, Ruto has systems of the earth and only Kenya. And if he goes far, East Africa, but not the systems of heaven. It was a crime for you, men and women, carrying the anointing of God, to kneel behind a man. God wants an explanation from all of you. Why? And I took everything as he was talking to me, and I will read them as I noted, then explain. The kneeling of the men of God behind the president was not right. God chose his servants to carry his authority and ordain the earthly leaders because of the mantle upon them. What they did was wrong, and their authorities were taken away, and so God is demanding the gift that he placed over you. So let this one be known and let it be heard. So if you know you are a bishop, you are an evangelist, and you went on your knees, you know what to do. Find him in the secret place. Give your explanation. Let me now explain this, the impact of it to Kenyans. There are three authorities on earth. We have the military authority. We have the authority that comes from legislature. The highest level should be a president or a king. I don't know how to term that in English. Administrative. Yeah? Can we call it that way? Executive authority. The highest level is the president. Then we have the spiritual authority. Today, anything that president signs becomes a law. It has effect directly to the people he's leading. True or false? Today, any disagreement that the military can have in this country will have an effect to the nation. True or false? How about spiritual office? You want to tell me it doesn't have effect? When your fathers, the gatekeepers, bowed down. Look at this. I want you to look at this spiritually. Now I'm explaining as a prophet so that you understand. God will never arise an issue without telling his prophet, so that the prophet can tell people so that they understand. Leave these funny things you are being told. Oh, God has said. God says when God accuses, he tells his prophet to explain the effect, because he's a righteous and justice God. He doesn't just say, I will beat you without giving an account to why. When he told Abraham, I want to destroy Sodom, he told Abraham, go and confirm their iniquities and tell me if they are not worthy the punishment. When Abraham came back, told God, surely, I've not even found one. When your pastors went behind the president and they were the first one to kneel, they opened the spiritual gates. Then the president was told to kneel. He opened the executive gate. Then when Ben-Hinn knelt, he summoned the powers. And each pastor who did that, they will start burying members of their churches. People will be dying like bees, like flies in their churches. And they cannot stop it because they opened the gate. And asked God, is this the reason why you removed me from Kenya and you brought me to Dubai for 14 days? And God told me, yes. Remember the dream, 2014. And I understood the dream. And I know many people have been asking, what does Prophet Samuel say? I am not here to entertain. I'm not a news anchor. I'm a voice of God. I only speak when he speaks. When he's silent, I'm silent. Because there's so much that he assigned me to do. But I'm here to tell Ben-Hinn, this country has prophets. Those demons will not survive here. They will not survive here. No innocent Kenyan will die as a price. And Ben-Hinn, you understand what I'm talking, because we are all in the spirit. You cannot go to sleep in graves and bring those spirits here in Kenya. It will not work. Kenya has prophets. Tell Kenyans the truth. Who funded the prayer meeting? I, the Lord, am not a thief to steal. Tell Kenyans the truth. This is the government. This is for the government. Tell Kenyans the truth. I, the Lord, am not a thief to steal. Don't use taxpayers' money to do meetings in my name. When I know how many Kenyans are sleeping with empty stomachs, when I know how many widows are suffering, I hear their prayers every day. I know how many orphans can't go to school, yet you are taking their taxes, funding and spending on things that are in the name of the Lord, and I'm not in them. And if I was to be asked for advice to the president of Kenya, I will tell him this as a prophet. Lead Kenya politically. Leave spiritual matters away. You are a president of Kenya, but not a priest of Kenya. If I was to be asked for opinion as a prophet, then I will tell the president, lead the nation politically. Lead the nation executively, but get out of spiritual things. You are not a priest of this country. You will take this country into some covenants that you don't understand, and the effect will become worse to our generation. And for the men of God who are surrounding the authority with lies, continue. I didn't choose you. He who chose you will deal with you. I have nothing to tell you. Continue feeding your stomachs with lies in the name of God. He's not an image. He's a living God. At his own time, he will come to defend himself with actions. So go ahead. Form more lies. Form lies and tell Kenyan lies in the name of God. Listen to me. God is a God of order. If Reinhard Bonnke was mistreated in this country, he is no more, but his anointing is still working. The anointing is in Kolenda. Why couldn't they form themselves a group and they go to Kolenda in United States and say, the Spirit of the Lord has spoken to us that there was this and this and this harm that was done to your spiritual father. We have come to seek forgiveness through you because you are the one carrying the mantle. When did Ben-Hinn become the chairman of Heaven Things? That you say you have called Ben-Hinn to come and forgive Kenya. If there was anything that was done wrong to Ben-Hin, they would have gone to Ben-Hin. Ben-Hin has no power over the ministry of Reinhard Bonnke. Ben-Hin has no power over the ministry of T.S. Osborne. Those people, they left mantle. Even me, if I was to die today, I will leave mantle to somebody. If God tells me today, Lucas, I want you, I will pass this mantle. Elisha tried to die with it. It was passed even through the bones. Are these not lies? If they know the men of God who are mistreated, those men of God did not die with the authority. They passed the authority. What Elijah did not finish, Elisha finished. The mantle will always pass to somebody when your time is over. Even me, it was passed to me. So when did Ben-Hin become the chairman? If it's not corruption and stealing. Do you think the sin of a nation like that one, God will speak to one person? We have men of God in this city. They have labored for the gospel. I don't care about their dramas, but one thing I know, they have labored for the gospel. Someone like James Nganga, Harrison Nganga, and many. We know men of God who has labored for this city.
People from China have stolen my heart.
I have good news for you.
Yes, sir, tell me.
Apostle Ezekiel.
Apostle who?
Ezekiel.
From where?
From Kenya.
Okay.
The people of Kenya know him.
Okay.
Very well.
Yes, sir.
He has said the man of God should be left to pray for the anointing for Kenya. He's going to postpone his program. Tomorrow he's sending in $100,000.
Did you hear that? Did he hear you?
Yeah. I hope he has heard me.
Say that again.
Apostle Ezekiel says that the man of God should be left to release the anointing. You should not be doing this. You should be releasing the anointing on Kenya. It's time for Kenya to pay the price.
We did that yesterday.
He said that's what needs to be done. So tomorrow he's sending in $100,000.
Well, God bless that dear man.
Amen.
But I gotta tell you, I did not wanna go home back to the United States knowing that this man and the committee have a burden. We have to make sure the burden is lifted. Because I really have fallen in love all over again with the people of Kenya. And so, you know, I just wanted to be a blessing. And let me just finish praying for them and then we can dismiss. So, come. Thank you, Lord. Bless the work of his hands. So you see, God gave you more now. He went way beyond that. That precious man gave the 100,000. And now everything is left over for other things to do with the Lord's work. In Jesus' name, bless him, Lord.
And this prophet, his name is Prophet Dr. Samuel Misiba. The name of his ministry is Messenger Ministry International in Kisumu. So I will put the link of his full speech on the description so that you can watch the full video. And the one of Pastor Ngenga actually spoke in Kenya. According to my Kenya friend, he said that Nganga was talking to, according to people who also do the description, Nganga was angry with Pastor Ben-Hin because, in fact, according to the news, you can check it on the news, is there, that Pastor Nganga is angry with Ben-Hin because Ben-Hin did not recognize them. They actually organized program in Kenya According to them, they want to satisfy the nation. They want to clean the nation. They want Benihin to forgive them. If you look at what these prophets say, it's fine that it makes sense. Their pain, many of them spoke. You can actually see the full video, this video now. You can see the full video on our Facebook, where all of them spoke on the Facebook at Pastors Gis with Lady P. Just go there, you watch all their angry and pain. All their concern is that money that people donated. I also complain about that money. I complain. How can a pastor, how can you, being a man of God, I respect Benihim very well. I respect him. I thank God for his life. But I say no to that money he collected from Pastor Ezekiel Odelu. He collected 1.4 billion. Million rather. 1.4 million shillings. You watch the video after this, my speech. Okay? You watch the video. Now, he actually collected that money. Not only the man, and some other ones, and others. And according to Pastor Nganga said that they were asked to pay 1,000 each. 1,000 shillings each. Each of them should donate 1,000 shillings to invite Pastor Benihin. After donating the money, Pastor Benihin did not recognize them. In fact, he even went and collected another money from them and went home with it. According to Benihin, he said that he collected that money so that they can pay bill of that place, that event, and others. But the people has already made the contribution, and I don't just get it. Did Benihin actually went there to extort from them? Because that is their cry now, that Benihin came to their nation to extort money from them. And for that, no, they don't want any fallen pastors to come to Kenya to do whatever crusade, that they are also anointed. Don't forget that some days ago, Pastor Dr. Sam came out and condemned the one of Jerry Eze and said that they have anointed men of God in Kenya. Check the video, have it. In Ghana, rather. Why inviting Nigerian pastors and others to Ghana? That they don't value their own. Now, the same thing is happening in Kenya. But the pain and the agony of these people is the money that Benihin collected from them. If we must tell ourselves the truth, these people can never donate such money to Kenyan pastor. They can't. We like foreign things. And the way they even worship Benihin. They will even see him as their God during that program. Now, Benihin, another pain of this man, this prophet now, is that Benihin asked them to kneel down to their president, President Ruto. And don't forget that Benihin, after this the program, he went and visited the president, President Ruto, in his place. So, you see, I'm not against that going to visit him, but that is just their pain. Kneeling down for the president. I respect this president. I respect him and I love what he's doing. I like, as in, even him bringing himself to this level, worshipping God upon his level, he still loves God. We have to celebrate him for that. We thank God for his life. If we have such president in Nigeria, this our pain and agony will not be like much like this. You guys are privileged to have somebody like this. Kneeling down to worship him, or me to greet him, me, I don't know about. Prophet, easy. So this prophet is from Kenya. He's a fearless prophet. Many pastors will not say this because of what they will gain from the president. But their main pain is that money that Benihin collected from his people and ran away. My own pain is the money he collected from Ezekiel. Poor people in Ezekiel's church contributed the money, and you came from all the way from your place and collected that such money. You don't collect such amount of money from a pastor that has plenty. 99% of his members are poor. Or let me say 95% of his members are poor, and you collect such money from him. And don't forget that Ezekiel happened to be a man that was accused some months ago of being involved in this ritual they did in Kenya, in the name of fasting to meet Jesus Christ. He was arrested. I don't know how he paid himself out or whatever they did there, and he came out again. How could you? Don't you know that kind of place? Now, he pushed this man, in name of deliverance. The kind of push he pushed. You need to watch all these videos on our Facebook. The kind of push he pushed him in name of deliverance, in name of impartation. He just gave you that money so that you guys can snap picture together, do this thing together. And he will say, yes, I work with Benihim. Imagine. And he even told him what to do with the money. He said Benihim should change his, he should change his topic. That Benihim was preaching Kenya should know Jesus, Kenya should know God. He said he should change it and start preaching money. Kenya will be blessed. Imagine, is that not bribing? Is that not bribing in my own side? Kenya should know God. You have to pay you yourself. Now, Benihim should stop preaching. This is not what he's supposed to be doing. So there is no anointed man of God to prophesy to Kenya worth, if I must say. If Benihim is to go to Kenya, it must not be the special assignment, as this prophet said, Prophet Samuel. It must not be, we offended him, we must call him to come and pray. No. If you offended him, you call him, you know how to reach him, you ask for forgiveness. If he's going there for program, he should organize the program and go there. So we must not misinterpret all these things. If you look at this issue now, this scenario now, you find out that these pastors are the cause of this. They are the cause, not Benihim. I only blame Benihim of collecting such amount of money from a poor pastor. A pastor that somebody say, no, the man is rich. What about the members? Do you know the level of hunger that is in Kenya? Must he collect money from them? All these billionaires, pastors should stop organizing program, having target of money. Everything is not money. I understand that the program is money, yes. Everything is money, yes. But must you raise money from the poor people and collect such amount of money? Other ones, other donations did not even disturb them. The one that disturbed people is the one of Ezekiel. Some 4 days or 3 days later, the same Ezekiel came out and said that he's about to die. We have the video on Facebook. I can't put it on YouTube because he did not speak English, so many people will not understand what he's saying here. Okay, I'm sorry for that. He said that he's about to die, that he will die on February. Now, my question is this. Nobody knows whether February, next year, February or what. That he's about to go and meet his master. Is the money disturbing him? Is it the money, as in the money he collected, he donated? Is he high PP or whatever because of the money? I don't know. So let's end here, please. All I just want to say that this thing is wrong. Very wrong. So I will put the link so they can go there and watch the full video. Thank you guys for listening. Don't forget, this video did not target to defend their characters. It's other fair use. So credit to the source. See you guys next time. What is your opinion on this? What is your opinion on this? And I want to appreciate this prophet because he's fearless. He not even look at his president. He don't look at anything. He just, wah. See you guys next time. Shalom.
Nitakuja hapa na. Nilisema 2 point. Sasa nimekuja na zaidi ya hiyo. This is 2.6. This is 400. Hii ni kazi ya wiki moja. Hii ni kazi ya wiki moja tu. Sababu nilisemea hapa. Nikasema Jumapili nitaamini Mungu ndio nijue mambo ya hiyo kiwaja. Nilisema 2.3. Nikaenda kwa Apostle Wanda akanipatia 1.5. Na akanipa sadaka hizo ndio hizi. Hapa katikati kuna mtu alikuja akanipa 300, mwingine akanipa 100, hata ziko zaidi maana ya simu sikutoa. This is to show you my word and my God. So nikiogea mambo ya connection, ninaona hii. Nikiangalia mambo ya connection, ninaona hii. Ukimaidi neno lako, hiyo neno italeta hiyo spirit. Wanaume mwamke, iwezekani itukua ati hii roho tukunaya ni ya Qur'an na wanawake tu. Ati mwanaume akitazama mwanamke kwa mfano wa kulala naye, amelala naye. Sasa situlale na pesa basi. Situlale na magari. Situlale na mataito D. Tuchukue mataito D. Tutashidaka nyimbo hapo ya shetani. If you are not serious, sasa ukiona mimi napata hii. Angalia mimi nafanyanga namna gani. Angalia mimi nafanyanga namna gani hapa ukiweko. Gunia zangu 560 za mahindi nikapeana. Gunia 60 nikapeana. Nikapea watu 10,000 na mimi siwajui, nikapea wazee kila mtu 10,000. Apadacho mtu ndicho atakacho vuna. Mimi wakati wa pesa siwezi kwenda kulia kwa Mungu, siwezi. Kwa nini siwezi? Siwezi. Kwa jana pale kwa mkutano. Nilikaa hapo, nilienda tu kuangalia vile Mungu anamtumia. Sitaongea saa hizi. But something wrong somewhere. Ule mtu alistruggle. Alistruggle. Ni mwimbaji. Aliiba nikiwa hapo nyimbo akaiba akaiba. Mpaka apate pale. Na mimi nikajua hapa ndio hapa. Hapa. Mimi ni mtu wa mahesabu. Mimi nilikuwa nimewekwa kule. Kamesa kalikuwa pale. Huko. Hata nilitajwa na mtu moja tu. Kenya wani yuko hapa. Wale walikuwa pale wote angalia, wale walikuwa hapa. Salimia mtu mwambie mind your own business. Msalimie mwambie wewe enda. Enda ukiadanga. Nilikuwa hapo na nimeona ministry yangu. Tuko mbele. Nilitamani tu nipewe gita tu, nipige tu nyimbo mbili. What the deliverance ile ingekuwa hapo. Lakini naona Kenya haiwezi kunipokea mimi. Wanapokea Waganda. Waganda ndio wanapewa kiti. Ezekiel alikuwa amekaa mahali hata alitoka. Niliona Ezekiel tulikuwa tumeongea na yeye. Lakini niliona alikaa pale kwa mlango, alitoka mbele yangu. Hata kuambiwa ufanye mkono hivi. Halo? Hata kuambiwa Ezekiel ifanye mkono hivi. Hata pasanganga, where are you? Can you raise your hand? Mimi nilikuwa tu naangalia vile Mungu ananitumia na vile anamtumia. Nikajua hata mimi niko. Halo? Hata government ya Kenya msipo nitabua, government ya biguni inanitabua. Halo? Msipo nitabua mimi government ya Kenya, government ya biguni inanitabua. Halo? Nilitamani tu nipige gita. Niseme breathe in, out. Ula la 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 la.